Vyasavatar Stotra. Page 97. Pralayai payo hitale hitavanna sivedam vihitabahe Rachayatramakedam
Kodi Jale Zitavara Sivedam Vihita Vahitra Charitramakedam
97 Pralayai payo hitale hritavanna sivedam
Jai Jagadishare. Jai Jagadishare.
Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter Number 59, The Killing of the Demon Nara, Text Number
42.
ato muhurta ekasmin.
Aho muhurta ekasmin.
Nanagari shutashtriya.
Nanageru shutashtriya.
Yato payimi bhagavan.
Yato payimi bhagavan.
Tabad rupadaro vyaya.
Tabad rupadaro vyaya.
Atho muhurta ekasmin.
Atho muhurta ekasmin.
Nanagare shutashtriya.
Nanagare shutashtriya.
Tabadrupadaro vyaya.
Tabadrupadaro vyaya.
Atho muhurta ekasmin.
Atho muhurta ekasmin.
Nanagare shutashtriya.
Nanagare shutashtriya.
Yato paye me bhagavan.
Yato paye me bhagavan.
Tabadrupadaro vyaya.
Tabadrupadaro vyaya.
Text 42, chapter 59.
Aho muhurta ekasmin.
Aho muhurta ekasmin.
Nanagare shutashtriya.
Nanagare shutashtriya.
Yato payene bhagavan.
Yato payene bhagavan.
Tabadrupadaro vyaya.
Tabadrupadaro vyaya.
Yatha
properly
forms.
Dhara,
assuming.
Avyaya,
the imperishable one.
The imperishable one.
Translation. Then the imperishable Supreme Personality, assuming a separate form for each bride, duly married all the princesses simultaneously, each in her own palace.
译文之后，不朽的至尊之人为每位新娘采用一个单独的形体，在合适的时刻同时娶了所有的公主，每位公主都在自己的宫殿中。
Purport. As Srila Sridhar Swami explains, here the word yatha indicates that each marriage was duly performed. This means that the entire company of the Lord's relatives, including his mother Devaki, appeared in each and every palace and attended each and every wedding. Since all these weddings took place simultaneously, the event was surely a manifestation of the Lord's inconceivable potency. When Lord Krishna does things, he does them in style. So it is not astonishing that the Lord simultaneously appeared in 16,100 wedding ceremonies taking place in 16,100 royal palaces, accompanied in each palace by all his relatives. Indeed, this is the way one would expect the Supreme Personality of Godhead to do things. After all, he is not an ordinary human being. Srila Sridhar Swami further explains that on this particular occasion, the Lord manifested his original form in each of his palaces. In other words, to take part in the wedding vows, he manifested identical forms, prakasha, in all the palaces.
因此，正如聖書的 Swami 解釋這裡的日他一詞，指每場婚禮都適時舉行的。这意味着主的全部亲友陪同，包括他的母亲迪瓦奇都出现在每一个宫殿参加了每一场婚礼，因此所有这些婚礼是同时进行的。这件事件无疑是至尊主不可思议的能量的展示。当主 Krishna 做事时，他会别具一格地做，因此主由他的所有亲属陪伴，同時出現在16,100個宮殿中舉行的16,100場婚禮儀式中，並沒有什麼值得驚異的。其實，這才是人們期望至尊人格守神做事的方式，畢竟他不是一個普通的人類。聖書家 Swami 進一步解釋，在一個特別的事件中，主在他的每個宮殿都展示了他的原初形體。換句話說，為了答下婚禮的誓言，他在所有宮殿展示了相同的形體。Prakash.
Do you have any melody? Can you understand the English?
英文看得懂。
Tumarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chatsurnilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stavitam Yena Bhutale Svayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeyam Shri Guru Shri Yatapada Kamalam.Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sahara Jatam Sahagana Raghunatam Vitam Tam Sadvaitam Sarvadutam Parijana Sahitam
Krishna Chaitanya Devam
Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sarvana Lalita Shri Vishakhandikam Sya He Krishna Karana Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaye Vacha Patitanam Paranebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama So we're hearing the pastimes of Lord Krishna as described in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam by Sukadeva Goswami to Maharaj Pariksit. We heard how Lord Krishna came to live in Dwarka and he accepted 8 principal wives.
我们听到了Krishna他来到了多瓦卡然后接受了八位主要的妻子
And then he was asked by Lord Indra to take action against a demon called Narada
然后呢他也受到了主Indra的请求去呢歼灭这个恶魔Narada
Because this demon Narada It was very powerful, and Indra was not able to stop him in his activities. And this demon Narada was actually son of Bhumi, Mother Earth. When Lord Varaha picked up Mother Earth, from the bottom of the Garbhodak ocean. At that time, Mother Bhumi was impregnated by Lord Varaha, and she gave birth to the son Boma. So this demon, Boma, did you tell everything I said? Did you get the whole thing?
Varaha,
Okay. So the demon Varaha had taken the earrings from Mother Aditi, the mother of the demigods. And so Indra requested Lord Krishna if he could arrange to have these earrings returned. And he also told, Indra also told Lord Krishna that this demon Narada had taken 16,100 young ladies and was keeping them prisoner in his palace.
然后同一时间呢，主Indra呢也跟Krishna说了，这个恶魔Narada同时呢，就是把16,100位女子呢给囚禁了。And
these young girls were all daughters of kings. They were from royal families.
那这些女子呢，都是这些皇族的家庭的那个国王的女儿。
So they were suffering greatly in the prison. This demon Narada.
们被这个恶魔拿拉卡监禁，然后呢，承受很大的痛苦。
So then we heard how Lord Krishna came to this demon's palace and was surrounded by many different obstacles to stop people from entering.
然后呢，主 Krishna 就来到这个恶魔的这个宫殿，然后呢，这个宫殿的外面设计了很多的障碍，让别人进不去。
First of all, there was a great demon called Mura, who had three heads.
那首先呢是有一个恶魔叫 Mura, 他有三个头。
But Krishna killed this demon.
Krishna 把这个恶魔给杀死。
And when Krishna killed this demon, then the seven sons of this demon all came attacking Krishna.
所以当 Krishna 把这个恶魔给杀死之后呢，这个恶魔的七个儿子呢就出来攻击 Krishna。
And they were all killed by Krishna.
他们都被 Krishna 所杀死。
And then there were weapons of natural elements, like there was a water weapon, there was a fire weapon, there was an air weapon, all to stop people from entering the palace.
然后呢，又发射出这些火、水和风的这些武器，去阻止其他人的进入。
But Krishna destroyed all these weapons and entered into the palace and confronted Narakasura.
然后 Krishna 都把这些武器给击退，然后呢，进入到这个宫殿里面，然后就正面的跟这个 Naraka 交锋。
Naraka then came forward with a whole army, a huge army, and they all came to attack Krishna.
然后 Naraka 呢，还有他整个军队啊，都来到了，然后要跟 Krishna 去作战。
But Lord Krishna defeated Naraka and cut off his head with the Sudarshan chakra.
然后最后呢，主 Krishna 呢是把这个 Naraka 给杀死，用他的 Sudarshan 这个神碟。
So after killing Narakasura, then Mother Earth, the personification of the Earth planet, the deity, presiding deity of the Earth planet, she came forward and offered prayers to Lord Krishna.
当 Naraka 给杀死之后呢？地球女神呢，她就来到 Krishna 的面前，献上她的祷文。
And she glorified Lord Krishna as the supreme personality of God.
然后她荣耀主 Krishna 作为是至尊人格首神。
And then she also brought the earrings which her son had stolen. She gave them back, gave them to Lord Krishna.
然后呢，她也把她儿子之前偷走的这个耳环呢，给送给 Krishna。
Then we heard Lord Krishna took the earrings and he brought with him Satyabhama, and with Satyabhama riding on the back of Garuda, Krishna and Satyabhama went to see Indra in the heavenly planets.
然后带着这个耳环给予了他的儿子
Satyabhama，
然后呢就骑上这个 Garuda 的这个座驾，然后去见主 Indra。
So, Lord Krishna gave the earrings to Mother Aditi.
然后就 Krishna 把耳环呢还给Aditi 妈妈。
And when they were there in Swargaloka in the heavenly planets, that time, then Lord Krishna took a parijata tree and put it on the back of Garuda because he wanted Satyabhama to have this tree.
然后当他们去到这个天堂的星球 Swargaloka 的时候呢？主 Krishna 就拿了一棵树叫 Parijata 树，然后放在这个 Garuda 的那个背上面。
The flowers from this tree were very fragrant.
那这棵树上面的花呢是就是非常的芬香。
And even the bees from the heavenly planets, they would come down to the earth planet after the fragrance of these flowers.
就算连那些天堂星球的那些蜜蜂都会来到这个地球，想要闻这个花的香味。
So before the flower had been given to Rukmini, and Satyabhama was jealous that Rukmini had this flower, she had the Parijata flower, and Satyabhama wanted one.
那当时候这个树呢给了 Rukmini， 然后 Satyabhama 他就很嫉妒，然后他也很想要得到这个树上面这些花。
The flower was flower was given to Rukmini. Narada Muni gave one flower to Rukmini.
Narada Muni gave Rukmini this flower.
And so then Satyabhama was jealous. So Krishna said, "Don't worry, I'll give you a whole tree." So when they went to heavenly planets, they took the tree. But Indra got angry. And complained that this is our tree, you can't take the tree.
然后他就生气，他说这棵树是我们的，你不能够拿走。
But they fought, but Krishna was victorious.
他们呢就打架，最后呢 Krishna 是胜利。
So it showed how foolish sometimes the demigods are.
那就这就展示有时候半神是那么的愚蠢。
And how in this material world conditioned souls we become so attached.
也显示了在这个物质世界，生物体是这么的依附。
And we think we are the proprietor of things.
然后我们以为我们是这些财产东西的一个拥有者。
We don't recognize that Krishna is the real proprietor of everything.
我们没有去清楚的知道，其实 Krishna 是所有一切的拥有者。
So then Krishna came back, and all these princesses, they needed to be taken care of, but somebody needed to take care of them.
所以当Krishna回到的时候，有这些女子们呢，她们呢需要被好好的照顾。
Because they've been taken away from their homes, their family, and the family won't take them back.
因为他们从那个家里被就是掳走了嘛，但是他们的家人不再接收他们了。
Because they've been touched by another man, nobody wants them.
因为他们被另外一个男子所触碰，没有人想再要他们。
So they all took shelter of Lord Krishna.
所以他们全部都托庇于主 Krishna.
When Krishna came there and freed them all from the palace where they were prisoners, then they all immediately accepted Krishna as their husband.
所以当Krishna来到这个监狱给他们释放出来之后呢，他们全部都接受 Krishna 作为他们的丈夫。
And Krishna is very kind to all souls who approach him and take shelter of him.
然后Krishna对所有那些接近他、托庇于他的灵魂都是非常的仁慈。
So he accepted all of these 16,100 young ladies, he accepted all of them as his wife.
所以呢，Krishna就接受了所有这些一万六千一百位的。 女子作为他的妻子。
And we are hearing that he performed a marriage. They had a marriage for each and every one of these girls.
然后我们刚刚听到了每一位的公主啊，都有她自己的一个婚礼。
And it was done. Their marriages were all done at the same time.
然后呢，这些婚礼呢是同一时间进行的。
Now how is it possible he could marry 16,100 women, all at the same time, in different places.
怎么可能在同一时间，但是不同的地方去迎娶16,100位的女子呢？
There was a palace for each of them.
然后每一位的公主都有她自己的宫殿。
Just like when you go to India nowadays, you see everywhere they have these marriage halls.
就是比如说你去到印度，你看到那个婚宴的场地。
You know, even the temple in Juhu, you know, it's marriage halls, you know. They use it, the place for marriages.
在朱古的庙宇里面也是用来举办婚礼的。
They get a good income from this, you know.
他们从这样的用途里面得到很好的收入。
To maintain the temples.
去维系庙宇。
So could you imagine 16,100 marriages?
你能够想象吗？16,100个婚礼。
All taking place at the same time.
是同一时间进行。
And Krishna is at each and every one of these marriages.
然后Krishna是出现在每一场婚礼当中。
Not only is Krishna at each and every one of the marriages. But Mother Devaki, his mother is there, and all of the relatives and all the people who come for the marriage, they're all there at each of the marriages.
所以呢，不只是 Krishna 他本人，还有包括他的母亲，还有全部的亲友都出现在每一场婚礼，参加每一场婚礼。
So not only did Krishna expand himself, but all of these other relatives of Krishna, they also expanded.
所以不只是 Krishna 去扩展他自己，他所有的这些亲友都扩展。So
how is it possible to do like this?
那这是怎么可能发生的呢？This
explain. This is a display of Krishna's inconceivable potency.
这里呢就解释是展示了 Krishna 这种不可思议的能量。
Somebody came yesterday at the book fair. And he said, I'm interested in philosophy and I like to read books, right?
那昨天在书展里面有人就过来说，我对这个哲学很有兴趣，我喜欢看书。
But he said, Hinduism, oh, it's too, what, how did he say, what did he say? Hinduism is all, he said that, you just have to believe it, everything. You just have
science,
to accept
no,
it.
No science.
Huh?
You say no science. It's just.
Yes, no science, right?
那就有一个男士，他就说，这个印度教他，他怎么说？就是他觉得是没有一个科学的根据，就是你只能够相信。
Yeah, he said he was reading Taoism, and it's more scientific.
他说他看这个道教，他觉得比较科学性。So
I told him, I said, well, science, you know, is very imperfect. They're always adjusting science. They can never come up with any eternal science. Whatever knowledge they have to revise it, constantly review it. So many different theories.
所以我就跟他说，这个科学啊，它是经常去不断的，就是会改变的。 它没有一种永恒的科学，有很多这些理论都会改变。
It used to be the corpuscular theory, but everything is corpuscles, you know.
那这个科学呢，它就好像拼图一样。And
then it became the wave theory.
然后出现这个波浪，就波浪一样。And
then it became the quantum mechanics.
理论，然后再变成这个。
Quantum theory, different energy levels.
不同的能量的层。But
still, they haven't come up with it. You know, Einstein wanted the one theory to explain everything, the one formula which was going to explain everything.
但是他们很渴望能够得到一个方程式或是一个理论去解释所有的一切。But
they never found it. They could never come up.
但是他们是没有办法找得到。The
more they study the material nature, the more they realize how complex everything is.
他们越去研究这个物质的自然的话，他们就发现是如此的复杂。So
science learns something about it, but there's so much more they never learn.
所以呢，这个科学呢能够理解到一些，但是他没有办法理解一切。Because
they are. Science is only dealing with the material energy. We don't have any knowledge about spiritual energy. So to actually understand, to get some enter into Krishna consciousness, first thing which is very important is to understand that there is such a thing as inconceivable energy.
所以呢，去接受进入 Krishna 知觉呢，第一步就是要知道，其实有一种是不可思议的能量。We
give the story about the frog in the well. Frog is trying to understand how big is the ocean.
我们有一个故事，讲这个井底之蛙，就说这个青蛙在井里面没有办法理解大海的浩瀚。The
other frog came to, I went to the ocean, and the frog, well, how big is the ocean? Is it four times as big as my well?
然后一只青蛙去到这个大海回来的时候，就跟那个井底之蛙说, 经理抓就问他，他那个大海是不是我这个井的四倍
is it 100 times bigger than my well?
是不是比我这个井大一百倍？
The frog can never understand how big is the ocean.
所以这只青蛙没有办法去理解大海的海岸。
People try to understand Krishna by their material senses. It can never understand.
所以人们他们想要靠自己的物质的感官去理解 Krishna 的话，他们是没有办法理解的。
And people try to understand nature of life by their material senses.
他们又试图用他们的物质的感官去认识这个物质的本质。
They don't understand that there's a spiritual energy which is the basic principle of life.
他们不知道这个生命的那个基本的、那个根本的，其实是这个灵性的能量。
They want to explain everything by their material formulas.
他们想用自己物质的这些程式去解释。
But if we want to begin to understand Krishna, the first thing is to understand is.There are things far beyond our mind and senses.
所以我们要去认识 Krishna 的话，第一步就知道，其实有一些事情是超越我们的感官还有心意的。
It's very difficult for materialistic people.
对于这些物质主义者来说是非常困难的。
So how to help them understand the inconceivable potency?
那怎么样可以帮助他们去了解到这个不可思议的能量呢？
Lord Chaitanya gave them the chanting of the holy name.
然后主 Chaitanya 就给予我们这个唱诵圣名。
Let them chant Hare Krishna mantra.
让他们去念诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
And Srila Prabhupada give more mercy by arranging for prasadam.
圣帕帕德呢给予更多的仁慈去安排这个菩萨。
But ordinary people are not intelligent enough to understand that there could be such a thing as inconceivable potency.
一般的人呢，他们没有办法理解有一种不可思议的能量是存在的。
But I remember one time I went with Jayadvira Swami. We went to this college in America, and.And Jayadvira Swami was preaching to them about Krishna. And so then this one student said, well, where does Krishna come from?
然后我记得有一次跟 Jayadvira Swami 一起去一所美国的大学去就是讲课这样子，然后有一个学生就问 Krishna 从哪里来。
And he would know Jayadvira had been explained, everything comes from Krishna.
然后 John Vita 他就解释说，所有一切源自 Krishna。
And this student, this dumb student, said, where does Krishna come from?
然后这些学生非常的迟钝，他们就又问 Krishna 是这些东西是从哪里来 ？Krishna 从哪里来
？So everything has to come from something. So where does Krishna come from?
哦，所以说一切都是源自 Krishna 的话，那 Krishna 是从哪里来的？
Krishna is the source of everything. Everything, there's nothing apart from Krishna.
其实 Krishna 他是所有的一切，一切都是源自他，在他以外没有其他的。
You have to understand there's inconceivable potency.
所以我们需要明白到是有这一个不可思议的能量。
And we see the examples of inconceivable potencies in nature every day.
那我们可以从这个大自然里面看到这个不可思议的能量。
Just like the sun is shining, giving off so much heat and light every moment.
那我们可以看到这个太阳每时时刻都发出这个光芒，给予我们光和热。
The heat and light which come from the sun in one second is enough to heat this whole planet for hundreds of years.
所以呢，从这个太阳里面发射出的这些光和热。只是一秒钟啊，就能够去照亮，我们这里一百年了，一百年。
The sun is bright, burning every day. The heat and the fire, the heat and light coming from the sun every day for hundreds and thousands of years. It's been like this.
然后呢，已经过就千百万年，太阳都是这样每一天去照射着。
Do you know any fire like that? Can you light the fire which will burn like that?
你有没有见过有一团火可以这样去发出光热？
This is inconceivable potency.
所以这个就是不可思议的能量。
It's similarly, the atoms are pervading everything.
然后原子呢是充满所有的东西。
The atoms are so small, they're tiny, you cannot see them.
这些原子呢是如此的微小，我们没有办法看见它。
But they're there everywhere.
但是它们是无处不在的。
You can see.
也是不可思议。
We have to understand Krishna is the source of all inconceivable forces.
所以我们要明白到 Krishna 是所有这些不可思议能量的源头。
And when he comes in this world, then he displays his inconceivable forces.
当他来到这个世界的时候，他就展示他这股不可思议的能量。
And one of the times which he displayed this inconceivable potency was when he married these 16,100 people.
其中一个事件去展示他这个不可思议的能量，就是他同一时间，迎娶了16,100位的公主。
And that he could be with each of them simultaneously.
然后呢，他是同一时间跟他们在一起的。
It's not difficult for Krishna.
对 Krishna 来说，一点都不困难。
He's just displaying his inconceivable powers to them.
他是展示了他这股不可思议的能量。
Each of the queens, they want to have their husband with them, naturally.
那每一位皇后都希望她的丈夫陪伴着她。
And Krishna's parents and relatives, they all want to be the marriage. They want to see Krishna's marriage.
那 Krishna 的所有的亲友都很想去见证 Krishna 每一场婚礼。
So Krishna fulfills their desire.
所以 Krishna 就做出了这个安排，满足他们的愿望。
Ordinary people, they think this, oh, this is just stories, this is not real, this is, they cannot accept.
那一般人就把它看成是一个故事，他们没有办法接受。
To the materialists, they'll never understand.
所以这个物质主义者，他们是没有办法去理解。
But Prabhupada said, even hearing the pastimes of Krishna, he said that. See, even if they think it's a story, still it's purified. Prabhupada writes in the Krishna book, this Krishna book will be good for three kinds of people. For those people who are endeavoring to become Krishna conscious, very good for them to hear about Lord Krishna.
对于那些呢，很想在这个就努力的成为，就是变得有 Krishna 自觉的人呢，聆听这个 Krishna 这个快乐的泉源的书非常好。And
for those people who are already fully Krishna conscious, who are practicing pure devotion, they'll take great pleasure in hearing the pastimes of Krishna.
对于那些已经拥有 Krishna 自觉，在练习这个纯粹的奉爱的人呢。 他们非常，他们聆听Krishna的活动的时候非常的欢喜。
And for those people who just like to hear mundane stories, who just like to read books and novels and so, they can also take pleasure in hearing pastimes of Krishna.
但是他有对于那些他们喜欢去看那些小说啊、世俗的这些文学的人呢、啊，他们去聆听阅读Krishna这些逍遥时光都是非常好的。
Just like that woman from England, she wrote these books about this boy, Harry Potter. And so many people, oh, they're all, you know, they all love to hear it and to watch the movies and everything.
So, this is just taking some
deviation, it's a perverted form of Krishna's past.
就是 perfect 就是一个反义。
Krishna is the actual origin of all drama, all pastimes, all lila. They're all there in Krishna.
所以 Krishna 的所有的这些戏剧啊、逍遥时光啊、活动啊，其实都是源自于 Krishna 的。
We hear about Krishna. We hear about his. We hear about the Shyamantaka jewel goes missing and who's stolen it, it's a whole big plot.
我们聆听这个沙巴达卡宝石给偷走了，听到这个阴谋，然后都是一个很大的一个就是剧本。
And then there's also the family intrigue, the politics between the two, the Kurus and the Pandavas, and the feelings between them, and the rivalry and the jealousy.
然后聆听这个两大家族他们之间的这个斗争啊，政治啊，然后他们的内心的感受啊。
These things are always portrayed in the Bollywood movies, right?
其实这些在那些 Bollywood 的电影里面都有展示。
Kidnapping the young girl, running, getting married.
然后把那个女孩子给就是掳走，然后绑架了，然后呢的这些桥段都有。
So all of these things are here in Krishna's pastimes.
这些在 Krishna 的相时光里面都有。
Modern life, to modern movies and theater and everything is all taking perfected forms of the original Krishna.
所以呢，这些现代的这些话剧啊，或是电影呢，其实都是Krishna 的笑时光活动的一个，抄袭。
Krishna performs his pastimes for the pleasure of his devotees.
Krishna 去上演这些笑时光，是为了取悦他的奉献者。
So that we can relish hearing more about Krishna's activity.
所以我们可以品尝，然后聆听更多 Krishna 的笑时光。
Any comments? Questions?
有没有那个分享的或是问题？
How did that young man respond to Maharaj in the book bag?
He didn't respond.
He didn't.
Oh.
Speculative philosophy is hard for them to accept something.
他们去认识这些一些思辨的，哲学，所以对于他们来说很难接受。
We could have brought some of the books from Bhaktivedanta Institute, showed them some of the scientific presentations of Krishna consciousness. We do have our scientific branch of Krishna consciousness.
我们可以带一些书是。是有讲述描述我们 Krishna 自觉里面比较科学的一面。
There's a book, Scientific Basis of Krishna Consciousness.
有一本书叫 Krishna 自觉的一个科学根据。
It's a very nice little, very short book, very small, not very big book.
是有一本小书。
But very well presented.
是写得很好的。
Sometimes good to have these kind of books for people like that. I mean, of course, it doesn't really. They're often narrow-minded people and difficult to get.
所以有可能带一些这样的书籍对这些人会有好处，但是有时候他们的思想太狭窄了，也很困难让他们去理解。
But if they do have a genuine interest.
但是如果他们是很真诚的。
If they're actually interested in science, the science leads to philosophy, and the highest philosophy is the Vedas.
所以，这个科学最高的哲学其实就是《吠陀经》《韦达经》Vedas.
It's not that we go from philosophy to science. You're meant to come from science to philosophy.
不应该是从这个哲学去到科学，应该倒过来，科学。就是这个是哲学引导这个科学，不是科学引导哲学。
All these scientists, they all become philosophers later on.
现在就是科学家之后就变成了哲学家。
Managing.
你的问题是？
刚刚，
孟妈妈
已经解释了一些就是在那个书展上面，有位先生就是属于。
So when we meet this kind of mental speculators, we are not able to convince them. So shall we not talk to them or just distribute them prasadam?
Yeah, prasadam is good preaching.
对，发发 prasadam 是很好的传教。
Difficult to convince people who are speculators, but the chanting of Hare Krishna mantra, kirtan, nice kirtan, you know, and prasadam are good preaching.
所以很难说服这些思辨者，但是很好的 prasadam 还有很好的 kirtan 可以去 帮助他们。
So, with all of our activities, there should be the chanting of the holy name. Some
prasadam.
Because if you just argue with people, you can go on arguing endlessly with them and get nowhere. But if we give them, if they get the holy name, then their mind can become
但是如果他们能够接受到圣灵的话，他们的心意就会变得平和。And
prasadam will also purify that heart.
Prasadam 也会净化他们的心。
Of course, we do discuss some philosophy with them.
当然，我们也会跟他们讨论一下这个哲学。
But you don't want to argue with them.
但是不想跟他们争辩。
Better to try to find people who want to hear.
应该去找一些人，他们是渴望去聆听的人。If
people are very atheistic and blasphemous, then we don't want to waste time.
如果那些人是非常的，就是无神论的，或者是他是那种很激进的，然后我们就不要花太多的时间在他们身上。
Bye.